Wolves are typically large animals, larger than most dog breeds, but the Arabian wolf is about the size of a German Shepherd, the smallest wolf subspecies found on the harshest environments on Earth. This wolf is built for the Arabian desert, hence its scientific name, Canis lupus Arabs. Being a subspecies of the gray wolf, DNA analysis and mitochondrial studies shows that the Arabian wolf is one of the oldest and most genetically distinct subspecies of the gray wolf, estimated to have diverged from gray wolf populations between 400 to 500,000 years ago. As gray wolf spread across Europe, Asia, and North America, some migrated into the Middle East, where they become isolated from northern populations due to the vast deserts and mountains, leading to a limited gene flow and allowing natural selection to carve out a wolf that could survive extreme desert climate. So, how do these wolves cope with desert living? The first answer lies in their anatomy, which is a testament to its remarkable adaptation to the harsh desert environment. Its smaller and lighter body mass minimizes energy expenditure and helps retain less heat, essential for survival in a habitat with scarce food and water. Their slender body frame and long thin limbs enables the wolf to efficiently cover vast distances in search of prey and water sources. One of the most distinctive features is its large pointed ears, similar to those of fennec foxes, acts as radiators, allowing heat to dissipate from blood vessels close to the skin surface, effectively preventing overheating in the scorching daytime temperatures. The thin and sparse coat, usually pale gray or sandy brown, reflects up to 80% of solar radiations and provides camouflage against the desert backdrop, aiding in stealth while hunting. The Arabian wolf's highly efficient kidneys concentrate urine, reducing water loss, while its ability to extract moisture from prey and consume desert plants helps it survive long periods without direct water intake. Being nocturnal allows the wolves to avoid the extreme heat of the day, further conserving water. Its thick padded paws and specialized toe arrangement are well adapted for walking on hot, sandy, and rocky terrain, providing traction and preventing injury. Additionally, the Arabian wolf's flexible diet, which includes small mammals such as the hyrax, birds, reptiles, insects, carrions, and plants, combined with a slower metabolic rate, allows it to endure long periods between meals. Socially, the wolves hunt alone or in small family units to reduce competition for limited resources, and it seeks shelter in burrows or rocky crevices during the hottest parts of the day to conserve energy and water. These anatomical and behavioral adaptations collectively enables the wolves to thrive in one of the world's most unforgiving environments, which include arid, semi-arid and mountainous habitats, but also thrives in isolated oasis areas, and some maintain a secret urban edge territories. But this urban incursion is dangerous. Why? Because scientists have discovered evidence of hybridization between Arabian wolves and feral dogs in certain regions, leading to a mixed genetic lineages that threaten the purity of the Arabian wolf subspecies. This interbreeding raises concerns about the genetic integrity of the species, prompting researchers to investigate the event of hybridization and its potential impact on the survival of the Arabian wolf. But their vulnerability doesn't stop there, because genetic analysis shows that Arabian wolves have low genetic diversity due to their small population size and isolated habitat, making them more vulnerable to diseases and environmental changes, prompting conservationists to develop strategies like translocating individuals between isolated populations to enhance genetic diversity. But the good thing is that the Arabian wolf exhibits a unique non-territorial behavior, unlike its northern relatives that fiercely defend their territories. Due to the scarcity of food and water in the desert, Arabian wolves roam vast overlapping areas in search of resources, avoiding direct confrontations with other packs or predators. This lack of rigid territory can also help push genetic diversity for wolves looking to start a family. However, wolf pairs can't meet up without communication, which is also distinct. Their howls are shorter, higher pitched, and less frequent compared to other wolf subspecies. They rely more on subtle body language and scent markings to communicate and coordinate within their small family units. This quiet and elusive behavior allows them to avoid detection from larger predators and human threats, enhancing their survival in the harsh desert environment. In terms of breeding, Arabian wolves mate for life, with both parents playing active role in raising the pup. Breeding typically occurs between October and December, with 2 to 4 pups born in the spring. The lifespan of an Arabian wolf in the wild is around 5 to 7 years, though they can live up to 12 years in captivity. Historically, the Arabian wolf holds cultural significance in Middle Eastern folklore, often symbolizing cunning and resilience. Additionally, some researchers believe that the Arabian wolf played a role in the domestication of local dog breeds, as interbreeding between wolves and ancient dogs may have contributed to the genetic makeup of certain breeds native to the region. The Arabian wolf's population is currently declining due to habitat loss, human-wildlife conflict, and hybridization with feral dogs, which threatens the genetic purity of the subspecies. It is classified as least concern by the IUCN. But conservationists warn that localized populations are at risk of extinction. Conservation efforts are underway, including monitoring populations, managing feral dog numbers, and translocating individuals between isolated groups to increase genetic diversity. Additionally, educational campaigns are being conducted to raise awareness and reduce human-wolf conflicts, aiming to protect this unique and resilient predator from further decline. Another mysterious dog is the short-eared dog, a dog you haven't heard of. Feel free to have a watch, and as always, stay curious, stay wild, and thank you very much for watching.